Many of today's largest and most successful YouTube channels are using an annotation like this one as a call to action to get more subscribers. In this tutorial, you'll learn how to add one to your own videos, and a little bit later on, I'll explain how you can get access to this graphic, which you can use in all of your own videos with no restrictions. Okay, step one. If you're going to use a graphic, add that graphic in your video project with your video editor. I use Adobe Premier CC, which I pay a monthly fee to access, but you can use practically any video editor to do this. Step 2. Go to youtube.com, make sure you're logged in, and then click on your logo in the top right corner, then click on Creator Studio. Step 3. Go to the Video Manager, and click the drop-down box next to the video that you want to add the annotation to. Then click Annotations in that drop-down box. In this case, I know exactly where that graphic shows up, so I'm going to scrub to that second mark in the video. Step 4. Click Add Annotation. I use Label, but you can actually use any of these. If you're not using a graphic, just make sure that the label isn't blocking something important on the screen, like your face. If you are using a graphic, position the label over it like this. Step 5. Add a call to action to the annotation. Be careful not to sound too pushy, and of course use proper capitalization, spelling, and grammar. You can change the size of the font so that it's a bit easier to read if you'd like. Step 6. Check the box that says Link, and then in the drop-down menu to the right of that, choose Subscribe. It will ask you for the username. If you're not sure what that is, here's how you can find it. Go to youtube.com, then to Creator Studio, then click View Channel. This shows you your public-facing channel page. Your username is everything in this URL string after channel and then forward slash. Step 7. Next, you want to set an endpoint for the subscribe annotation. If you're using a graphic, you'll want the annotation to disappear when the graphic does. You can use the time entry field, or you can just use the handlebars in the scrubber to do this. Step 8, save and apply changes, and that's it, you're done. Before you go ahead and set this up on your own channel, there's something you need to know if you're going to be effective at using this on your own channel. Do not put the annotation at the very beginning of the video. Before you can ask people to subscribe, you need to provide value to them. And putting annotations at the very beginning of the video is tacky and it will drive people away. It also helps to put the annotation at a point in the video where you provide some sort of verbal call to action. You might say something like this. Before I get into the last tip, I just wanted to say thank you so much for watching. If you think you might want to see more content like this, feel free to click the subscribe button that you see on the screen now. I promised I'd give you this graphic for free. To get that, just follow the link in the description that's labeled Get the Subscribe Button Here. This will take you to ytfoundation.com, where you can of course download that and also see a full written version of this tutorial.